So today I'm going to talk about how to manage fever in children at home. So fever is a very common problem in children. Many children get 2 to 4 episodes of fever in a year, and parents often get confused and anxious when their child gets fever, and they call me and ask, "Doctor, what to do?" So today I'm going to discuss about what is fever, how to record temperature in children, which thermometer to use, whether fever is good or bad for children, what you can do at home when your child has got fever, what you should not do when your child has got fever, when you should take your child to doctor when your child has got fever, and when it is an emergency and you should go to a hospital when your child has got fever. So today I am going to discuss about all these things. So first of all, what is fever? Fever is actually when your body's temperature goes above the normal temperature. So generally the normal temperature of our body is between 97 to 99 degree Fahrenheit, and average temperature of the body is 98.6 degree Fahrenheit. So fever usually is above 99 degree Fahrenheit when you measure in axilla. When you measure in oral cavity, that is when you put the thermometer under the tongue, if the temperature is above 100 degree Fahrenheit, that is called fever. So what happens is oral temperature is 1 degree higher than the axilla. So that's why if the temperature in axilla is more than 99 degree Fahrenheit, it is called fever. Whereas in oral cavity, if it is more than 100 degree Fahrenheit, that is called fever. How to measure temperature in children? So always use digital thermometer to measure temperature in children. For less than 2-year-old children, always use axilla for measuring the temperature. For more than 2-year-old children, if they are cooperative, you can put the thermometer under the tongue. And after use also, you have to clean it with sanitizer or soap water. This is very important. Now, another important thing is what I tell parents in my clinic, always maintain a temperature chart when you are measuring fever for your child. So what happens is parents actually measure the temperature and they forget about it. So that's a very big problem. So whenever you measure temperature, always write it down with a date and time and what degree of fever it was. Fever happens because of the body is trying to fight any infection, and because of this immune response to any infection or illness, there are a lot of chemicals released in body, and these can lead to our body's temperature going high. So that is why fever happens. So fever is not actually a bad thing. Fever is actually a good thing. It shows that our body has the immune capacity to fight against the infection. One more important thing I would like to tell parents is, when we check temperature by our hands and we feel like the baby's body is warm, that is not the correct way to measure temperature, because baby's body may be warm, but if it is not above 99 degree Fahrenheit, then it is not fever. Other question which parents commonly ask me in the clinic is, my baby's forehead or the head is always warm. So what happens is baby's head is little big compared to their body, so the brain circulation is much more higher than other parts of the body in baby. So baby's head may feel warm in general. So that is not actually a fever. Coming to what we can do if your child gets fever. So very important thing to remember is, whenever the child is getting fever, to maintain a temperature recording. So what I mean is, you maintain a temperature chart. What you do is, every time fever you are measuring, no matter whether it is fever or not, you just, whenever you are putting thermometer in a baby's body, whenever you are recording temperature, just note down the date and time of the temperature along with the temperature degree. So how much ever is the temperature, you note it down. So over a period of 3 to 4 days, whenever you record this temperature with date and timings, you will understand how many times fever is coming in a day, how high the fever is going. So that can reassure you. What happens is, if the fever is actually coming down in day by day, so your anxiety comes down, okay, my fever is settling down. For us also, it is very important that we see that the fever is coming down in a day-to-day basis, so we also feel that our treatment is working. And if sometimes fever is not coming down or it is going up, we can always modify our treatment, add antibiotic or change antibiotic. So it is very important to record temperature chart. Next most important thing whenever your child gets fever is to give paracetamol. So whenever fever is above 99 degree Fahrenheit, you need to give paracetamol to the child. So paracetamol is the universal medicine for fever all over the world, and that is the only medicine which you can give safely to the child without much side effects. So what happens is, paracetamol usually is given in a dose of 15 milligrams per kg each dose. So each dose is 15 milligrams per kg, and you can give 4 times in a day when the child is getting fever at 6 hourly interval. So that is very important to know. Now another important thing which I want to tell you from my experience, many times what happens is, Paracetamol comes in different preparations. So for children less than 1 year, paracetamol comes in drops. So that is 1 ml of paracetamol. 1 ml of paracetamol drop contains 100 mg of paracetamol. So what happens is, this 100 mg per ml is a very strong, very concentrated form. Whereas in children more than 1 year, we use syrup. So syrup comes in two strengths. One is 120 mg per 5 ml, another is 250 mg per 5 ml. Two strengths of syrup come. So you should always check the doses of the paracetamol which your doctor has prescribed and the preparation which you have taken. What strength, whether you have taken a drop, whether you have taken 120 mg per 5 ml syrup or 240 mg per 5 ml syrup. And based on that, you should give. So general dosing is, if your child is 10 kg, your child will require 150 mg of paracetamol. So this is very important to know. Now, apart from the paracetamol, what else you can do? You can do sponging of the child. Sponging is very important to reduce the fever, because what happens is, due to the fever, there is a lot of heat generated in the body. So body becomes warm and child becomes uncomfortable and becomes cranky and cries a lot. So once you do sponging with lukewarm water or normal temperature water, that heat is lost and heat is dissipated, so child feels much more comfortable and relaxed. So this is what sponging should be done. Sponging should be done especially in the forehead, under the neck, back and the groin and armpits to reduce the body temperature. This is very important. Now next most important thing is, the appetite of the child actually goes down during the fever. So you need to give repeated multiple times liquid feeds. So basically you can give soups, you can make juices, you can give khichdi and all easily digestible food during the fever for the child. Now another important thing is clothing. So what happens is, parents often put very warm blankets or very heavy clothing on children during fever, but that makes the children more uncomfortable. So what we should do generally is put light clothing, so that whatever extra heat is generated in the body because of fever, that can easily get dissipated. Only if your child is having shivering or chills rigor, that time you can put another one warm blanket on the baby's body. But in general, fever, you need to use light clothing. Now coming to one important question which parents often ask is whether we need to bath our baby during the fever. The answer is yes, you can do bathing, but I prefer to do sponge bathing. What I mean is, you can use a towel to wet the towel in normal or lukewarm water and wipe the body all over, especially making sure that you wipe the areas where the dirt accumulates, that is under the neck, armpits, groin and behind the neck. These areas where the dirt or the sweat accumulates, there you should clean properly and wash the body all over with a wet towel. Now coming to when you should take your child to a doctor when he is having fever. So first important thing is, if your child is less than 3 months old and he gets fever, you should go to a doctor. If your child is getting high fever above 100 and it is lasting for more than 2 days, you should go to a doctor. During the fever, if your child is not eating well or if child is very lethargic, activity is less, then you should go to a doctor. If your child is actually having any rashes or any joint pain during the fever or headache during the fever, you should go to a doctor. Now, one more important thing is when to go to hospital or emergency during the fever. So there are few situations which are very dangerous during the fever where you should rush to a hospital or an emergency. That is, if your child has got fever with fits or convulsion, so then you should go to a hospital. Then if your child is become unconscious or confused, that means the child is not able to recognize you and child is not responding to calling, then you should go to a hospital. If the child has very high grade fever, more than 104 degree Fahrenheit, then it becomes very important to go to a hospital. If the child is actually not passing urine for more than 6 hours, or child has developed fast breathing, difficult breathing, or the pulse oximeter shows saturation below 94%. In corona season, this is very important. So in corona season, if your child is having fast breathing, difficult breathing, or saturation less than 94%, that means you should go to a hospital. That means it can be a serious illness. So these are the most important points which I wanted to tell you about fever. If you have any other doubts or questions regarding fever in children, you can ask in the comment section. If you like this video, please subscribe to the YouTube channel, share with other parents. Thank you for listening to us.